with affordable and reliable internet. And we do this by breaking the digital divide and supporting the goals of the Global Connect Initiative, which aims to connect 1.5 billion people by the year 2020. We have founded the Kelika team. We started off as a pilot project of TDI space. Microsoft had an initiative called For Africa, and they desired to improve the global competitive and digital in Africa. And they chose Mawingu as one such place to pilot this. So our pilot then included 8 hotspots, which were serving 5 schools, the county government of Laikipia, and some public libraries and health clinics. So as we expanded, then we built relationships with other people around Laikipia, mostly entrepreneurs having shops, whom we call merchants, so that they can sell internet bundles on our behalf. I remember that time I was not in Mawingu, but I know the Microsoft CEO came to Kenya, and actually when they were launching Windows 10, they did it in Mawingu. How have we moved from this pilot project initiated by Microsoft? There have been some investments into the company, and OPIC has been one such big fund into the company. We got a $4.1 million boost that helped us expand. And then we also got some investments from private investors, including Paul Allen's Vulcan, and University Foster, as well as organizations like USAID. How have we grown? Basically, if you are a student of business, there are various strategies which people can grow. But looking at our company, I see that we have used what the theorists call disruptive innovation. And disruption is described as a process where a smaller company with fewer resources, because my group is pretty small, can challenge establishing businesses, especially where there is need to improve products and services, and where that need is demanding for the big companies. Secondly, disruption have entrants targeting those areas where the big companies don't even want to go to, because they deem such places as uneconomical and not good for their businesses. So we decided that where those big companies suffer in terms of providing that experience that the user needs, we want to be there. And where those big companies don't want to be because they feel that those areas don't give them economic value, that's where Mawingu goes. So we saw an opportunity for serving the underserved and unserved areas, which is a new market, and then we aim to deliver internet at the very least price possible. What's our business model? How are we able to sustain ourselves? In a nutshell, we do business to business. We use partnerships. How have we used partnerships to grow the company? One, we partner with local entrepreneurs, or we case local entrepreneurs. We have found that if you want to have a sustainable business out there, then let you partner with that person. Let that person believe in what you want to do, and then empower them so they can also make something out of what you do. The second key plank of our partnerships is with local-based organizations and individuals for infrastructure, hosting, and relocation. One of the biggest challenges that most companies who do wireless communication, agent of just access, something that prevents them from rolling out across any given terrain is where to co-locate their infrastructure. At Mawingu, we partner with local-based organizations and we explain to them why it is important for them to allow us to host our infrastructure, and we agree particularly on an exchange of service and in some cases some small fee, and then they protect our infrastructure and they also keep it in there at a good cost. The third aspect of partnerships is with companies and groups with similar missions like ourselves. Example is Microsoft. Microsoft has a lot of programs on how to bridge the digital divide. The University of Strathclyde in Glasgow, Scotland, also does a lot of work on communication services for underserved and unserved populations and US aid. The fourth pillar of our partnerships is by working very closely with the local regulators. You'll know later in the afternoon that Mawingu was really the first company to undertake a device-based rollout. And we did it as a pilot. And it only came about by sitting down with CA, that I call CAK, and we discussed how this can potentially help this country bridge its digital divide, and then we move forward. So we have kept that in all we do. We have kept this very close to the local regulator. We keep on discussing what we want to do, how they can help us or enable us to help ourselves and so that we can help the communities that we serve. And then lastly, serious partnerships with the suppliers. For us to deliver internet very affordably, you see there's a couple of slides ahead, our internet is very affordable. We must have a good business deal with those who give us backbone as a cost. So we have very strategic partnerships with Liberty Telecom, for instance, in this country, and Jamin Telecommunications. We have a model in which we get bandwidth from them, such that this thing makes sense to us. And also Microsoft. You'll find out that a good part of our OSS, BSS, runs on Microsoft. And you know how sometimes Microsoft is deemed to be expensive. But for us, we have found a way in which we can work together with them, such that whatever we do becomes applied to them, and that helps us lower the cost of the Microsoft products that we use. Who's our target market? Consumer. We want to help reach the other 1.5 billion people, so we want to target the consumers. We do our internet at just about half a dollar for 380. That's really, really low. And half a dollar for 380 is something that, from our estimation, most of the people in the communities that we serve are able to afford. Our consumers use our service through a hotspot or a Wi-Fi zone. And what happens is that whenever you are in that hotspot service or the zone, and you have a bundle or an access code, then you are able to access the Mawingu network. And typically, most of these people use mobile phones for that. For us to be able to make this thing work, unlike the competition, even our least bundle, which is half a dollar, lasts 90 days. So if all you wanted to do was to come and check what was the price of maize in the market today, and then you want to go back to the shamba, and you come back again a month from today, your bundle will still be active. So we give you value for your bundle. Our product is Wi-Fi based. So our service or product is a Wi-Fi hotspot. And we are saying that consumers within a signal range or hotspot can purchase various bundles. They are ranging in size from internet-enabled devices, plus mobile phones, that are valued up to 90 days, as I mentioned earlier on. How do we do our Wi-Fi? We make it nomadic. That means you are able to move from one hotspot service to the other. In fact, for those of you who know Kenya well, currently if you drive on the Nairobi Nyeri Highway, all the way from Chaka is a pretty popular place, to Meru, you'll be having Mawingu hotspots. And if you have an active service, you can use it as you move from Chaka to Nagomoro, to the next town, as you move along. So you want to make the network pretty ubiquitous, but it's nomadic, so you can move with it. We have over 500 hotspots across an area measuring 1.5 kilometers as of today. Basically, this stretches around the foot of Mount Kenya. This network covers from towns to villages to hamlets. And the common trend seen across all these markets is that they want to be connected in the most affordable way possible, which Mawingu is able to deliver as I speak. How do you have these hotspots? I mentioned earlier that one of our key strategy is to partner with the local people, the merchants. So our hotspots are not really run by us. Our hotspots are run by people we call merchants. So these merchants take care of us. We install the hotspots. They take care of it. They give it power. They ensure that the thing is up all the time. They can look at it. And in fact, if you want to have our bundles, you can go to a merchant to buy that bundle. We don't send your bundle directly. The merchant will do that to you. So you call the third-party resellers. There are various categories. Typically, they'll be using shops. We call them Lucas here. They'll be doing their other stuff. So a shop will be selling food or household items. Later on, we found out there are some internet cafes and seller cafes who also act as merchants. But this will be a common shop selling many common stuff. And in addition, they become a Mawingu merchant so that they can help us maintain the hotspot and sell the service. We train them, we train these merchants so that they are able to actually provide first level support. Yeah, and where required, they can actually do one of the things before our person goes in there. You can imagine how wide the Ndege account will be. And this is to the remotest village in Ndege. Yeah. So sometimes we don't get there quickly, but the merchant will know how to do one or two things on our infrastructure. So these are our sample bundle and bundle prices. You can see this there is a half a dollar one, 300 megabytes. You have a dollar one and 500 megabytes. $3 at 2 gigabytes, and $10 at 8 gigabytes. All these valid for 90 days. What are the substitute products that we have, or what competes with us? Basically, the 3G mobile networks, the paid as you go services that they give. Of course, their advantage is mobility, but their greatest weakness from our perspective is cost. We are able to deliver a meg or a gig much cheaper than they can do. And in terms of our value proposition to the customer, we are typically 3 to 4 times the value for money compared to the 3G operators. For 3 to 10 times as valid for your bundle. So there's no brainer. Where we have a hotspot service, we can actually disrupt a 3G network operator. We also have homes, SOHOs, and small to medium enterprises. Though this is not our core market, but along the way, as we offer services to the consumers, you'll find a home who needs affordable internet, you'll find a definitely affordable internet, and who are also in areas which are underserviced, or not served, or require value for money, as we do. Even there, our price is still very affordable. So this will be built up areas, remote areas, farms, ranches, NGOs, and private homes. And for the homes, SOHOs and SMEs, we provide them a speed-based service, and that speed range from 1 megabit per second to 30 megabits per second. So these are a sample packages. You can see the lease package on thin air is written 2 megs. It's about 5,000 shillings, which is what, $50. And then the most expensive one on this list is 30 megs. Which is basically $449. What technology do we use? For our access infrastructure, we have a distributed network system. Basically, we have the backbone, and from the backbone, we expand it wirelessly to where our customers are. So our equipment will comprise of a point-to-point radio to receive the internet connection and a local wireless access point to distribute the Wi-Fi connectivity around the immediate proximity of the merchants, or business or home. Typically for the merchants, we target 100 meters radius. I know some of the equipment we have does better than that, but for power reasons and cost effectiveness, we make our hotspots serve 100 meters of radius. What about our OSS DSS platform? We use a robust and scalable custom built operational billing system. We call it ISD Mawingu. Very powerful system. And we support this by a fleet of Microsoft CRM and ERP cloud based applications, especially Microsoft Dynamics, the Navision, and the Dynamics 365. So the Microsoft Dynamics Nav, coupled with the ISD Mawingu, is the backbone of how we control the support and monitor our network. We have been a wireless internet service provider, but with the recent move to the cloud, we think that we'll soon stop calling ourselves a wireless internet service provider to a cloud-based internet service provider. And that diagram is a roadmap of where we are. At the center of it is cloud-based services based on Microsoft Azure. That's where everything will be spinning. In between, we have software-defined radios to use on our systems. We have software-defined core network. Currently, our routers, firewalls, are all software-based. We spin them on VMs, we configure them, and then they run. We are not using those hardware-based devices anymore. And then there is Move, especially in the device space. And the other day, this CAK had a glimpse of this when my colleagues were in South Africa for the Dynamics Spectrum Forum. There's Move now, we even have Spectrum being dynamically assigned. So we know we'll do it on TDSs because already technology is there for us, but we know even moving forward, this will be able to happen for any other spectrum. So that's where we're also heading. And then our business support processes are also on the cloud. So if our core network is on the cloud, our business support process on the cloud, our systems are on the cloud, then we have moved from wireless to cloud-based infrastructure. So how can you take advantage of Mawingu? Is there a way you can transfer knowledge? Yes, you can come with that, you are very good to do and try to do it. Or better still, from perspective, we have come up with a franchise model. So it is possible for us to have a Mawingu in whichever country you are in, whichever country you are in, and you have some argument on how to do that. And it will be very, very easy for you to do that, because we'll be able to run off our business systems, we'll be able to run off our billing system, we'll transfer technology to you, and the experiences. So it's very easy to become a Mawingu anywhere in any country. And that's a move that we want to aggressively push, like conjunction with Microsoft. So these are some of the schools that we serve over the country. There are so many. In the Kibe County, Nyeri, Meru, we serve so many schools. Those are just samples. Several. Some other social places that are schools, libraries, dispensaries, Red Cross in the UK. They are all served by Mawingu. This is a photo when the Microsoft CEO was in one of the schools in Nanyuki that Mawingu serves. This is one computer lab, again, that's being served by Mawingu. This is in the middle of a place where you don't get internet otherwise. This is a school in Old Majeta, in the Aspen Waters. So you can see they are fully in. They have access to internet. We provide them with solar power.